Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey, and you're watching another 15-minute photo challenge. Now, today I'm in the Peak District, and it's a place with big skies, so I'm hoping to get some amazing landscape shots, but also some little detail shots as well. So, no time to waste, let's get cracking. Right, okay, well, where to start? There are so many good places here that it's really hard to know what to start with sometimes. So whenever I'm faced with not knowing what to do, I like to do the obvious shots. So I'm just going to take a couple of nice straightforward landscape shots. Now the only problem I'm going to have there is the depth of field, because if I let the camera do its own thing, I'm going to end up with the heather blurred and the rock sharp, or vice versa. So I'm in aperture priority mode, and I'm going to dial in a nice aperture, something like f11, f16, to try and get a good depth of field. But of course you can also use that minimum depth of field to your advantage as well. So let's dial it right the way down, f4, big wide open aperture, just focus on the heather and let the background go out of focus. Lovely. Okay, now this area is known for producing millstones many years ago, and we're not far away from an old abandoned millstone production area, but there's a few abandoned ones here. This is a massive unfinished millstone, so well, let's take a shot of that as well. It's so big, I don't quite know how to do it. Let's see, let's come back here. Yeah, okay, this could work. Okay, now this is going to all be about compression, because I want to compress the distance from the millstone to the big lump of rock in the background, because it's quite a distance. But if I step back and zoom in, I can make that distance appear to be much shorter than it really is. And again, I've got to watch that aperture to make sure that everything stays in focus. Super. Okay, so that's stepping back, but let's go in close and do a wide angle version. Okay, so now I'm much closer to the rock, but I'm going to use the wide angle lens of my zoom, and that should make that big rock in the background appear way further back. Yeah, this should do it. This is about right. So I'm a little bit closer to the main big rock now, and I want to again do a nice wide landscape shot. And what I've got here is a nice little rock that I can put into the foreground. So if I use the wide angle lens, I can really try and make that appear bigger than it really is. And we've got the path that should give a nice little lead up to the rock. That's nice. It's going to move around slightly. Because that's beautiful as well. Look at that. This is the big skies I was talking about. Yeah, fantastic. Okay. Yeah, let's keep going. Hey. Well, it's typical, isn't it? You come over the next little rise and you find there's a much better part of rocks just a little bit further along. But this is a 15-minute photo challenge. I haven't got time to get to those, so I'm going to have to take the landscape shot from here. So let's see how it goes. Like that. Okay, Well, just below us there's a little quarry where they used to cut out the millstone grit and carve it by hand into millstones. And there's a couple of abandoned ones left down there. So let's just take a little walk down there and see what we can find to photograph. There's what, 3, 4, 5 millstones just abandoned, left, forgotten about. Great for photography. Let's see what we can get. Kind of like this one. This is a, looks like it's completely finished, just lying here. Let's go wide. Let's get down nice and low just to fill the gap between the stone and the background. Like that. Okay, well there we go. And unfortunately, well, time's well and truly beaten me. 15 minutes goes very, very quickly. So hopefully we've got some really good pictures. Even if we didn't, I've had great fun shooting them. I'm going to put them through the computer and see what we can come up with. I'm Gavin Hoey. Thanks for watching.